Louise Rowe and her Texan Playboys.
Everybody, the Texas Playboys are on the air. You're going to be listening to such stars as Buddy on the steel guitar, Joe Settlemyers on the guitar. Take it away there, Buddy.
John Stutler on the saxophone.
Dexter Rowe on that fiddle for you. Dale Morris on the fiddle. Lady that keeps it together, the glue of the band, ladies and gentlemen, Louise Rowe on that big bass. We're going to feature L.J. Pritchett down on the end. We're going to do a tune, Kind of Love I Can't Forget. Here's Dexter.
gander. We could live so happily.
Jay Pritchett. We got a treat for you coming now. We really, really do. How about a little steel guitar rag? Buddy's got that. Couple number one. Everybody.
By the way, that was Suzanne and Kilroy over here dancing for us.
All right. Big hand for our dancers one more time, if you would. You betcha. We have not had you clap for the hardest working drummer on the stage. Big hand Mark Minton back here, everybody. And now we're going to take a little bit of a break, and Louise is going to walk right over there and actually be interviewed by Carolyn Wills, or is it Tom?
By me.
It's by Tom, but, right over here.
But Carolyn, will, and after the interview, and Louise will be available for question and answers, then we'll proceed with music.
And then
so be thinking of questions, or be thinking of a story you remember when Bob Wills came to your town. First of all, I want to introduce Joel Foy. He will be with Christian Dosler on August the 14th, the History of Texas Blues. Not History of New York Blues, History of Texas Blues, right here on the 14th. This is Joel Foy. Also, this program is being sponsored by Malcolm and Kathy Duke. They have asked me not to have them stand, but they're in the back. So let's give them a hand. And the best way you can become my friend is join the Friends of the Allen Public Library, where it helps waive fines and sponsor these programs. Now you're going to hear one of them, a very exciting piece of Texas musical, American musical history. Louise, tell us about the time when you were a little girl and your daddy was teaching your brother some music, and you were over in the corner watching.
Well, excuse my voice. I used to have a real good voice, but I tore it up getting it out. Anyway, the tremor hit my voice. vocal cords. But when I was about 4 or 5 years old, my daddy, who was a music teacher, I had 7 older brothers. And so I was the little thing here, okay? And I was precious to all of them. But when it came to music, they didn't notice that I was anything but their little sister and my daddy's little girl. But I was over there singing the harmony parts by my ear and stuff that he was teaching them. I was over there doing all of that. And then later, he patterned their band, which was called the Seven Row Brothers Band, Western Swing. They patterned it after Bob Wills. They would listen to when he was on KVOO, and they would listen to their broadcast. And the sad part of it is that my daddy died before he ever got to know that I got to work with Bob Wills. And they listened to Bob Wills and patterned their band after him. But and here I was, a Texas Playboy riding their men's.
Tell them how you your ability to learn the dissonant harmony and meter helped you get on the band. The harmony part.
The harmony. I'm not following you.
When Bob Wills needed that harmony.
Oh yes. Bob hired me for an 18-day tour and just to sing, vocalist, solo. And all the other girls that sang with Bob Wills could yodel. And I thought, why does he want me, you know? But he needed a girl singer right quick for an 18-day tour. So he talked to my brothers, and they said, okay, she can go with you. And we went to California, and for 17 nights on that tour, I came up and sang my little solos. But then on the next to the last night, the 17th night, the guitar player couldn't make it. So they set up Eldon's guitar, and whoever wasn't doing anything could go over there and pick it up. And well, they were doing a song, and he was sitting over there, so I walked over and picked it up and started beating rhythm, because my brothers had taught me to play the chords to all of Bob Wills' songs. And so I went and picked up the guitar, and Bob turned around to me, and he hadn't talked much to me during that tour, but he turned around and he said, child, can you do that too? And I said, well, yes, sir. And so anyway, after that, a few songs later, the one that was playing the bass, he called him down to play the bass, and the one that played bass, as usually when Jack Lloyd sang, he had the guitar in his hand at that time. So Jack called me back, and I took the bass, and I played the song on the bass, and Bob turned all the way around, and he said, well, child, can you do that too? And this was next to the last night of the tour, and he had never said a word to me about working and becoming a real Texas Playboy. So after a while, well, Faded Love, of course, was the biggest thing there was back then. And the girl singer always stood on the right side of Bob. And I heard Bob say, got a request for Faded Love. Huh, I don't have anybody to sing the third part harmony. Well, Billy Bowman sang it on that record. You hear that real high voice. And that was Billy Bowman's voice on that. And Billy was off in the Army at this time. So Bob, he said that, and I heard him, and I walked over, and I said, Bob, I can sing that harmony. And he looked at me, and he said, are you sure, child? And I said, yes, sir, because I could do that better than I could do anything. I could, you know, sing any part of the harmonies. And so he kicked off Faded Love. And when it came, part of the story was that the guitar player, it wasn't there that night. He had been singing that part, harmony, on Faded Love. But Billy on the record has this real high voice, tenor. Well, Eldon couldn't sing it high. He had to sing it real low, and because he was a baritone. Well, that night, when I stepped up and sang that harmony part, my voice was up there where Billy's was on the record. And Bob was so thrilled. If you ever heard that holler that he did, really good. He did that in my ear that night. So I sang all of the harmony parts and things that the band did after that. And the next night, we were back in Dallas, where he hired me for the 18-day tour. Well, we were at the Baker Hotel, and when he called me up to sing a song, he announced to the crowd that the band was going back to California. They were going to do radio shows, TV tours, and everything, and I was going with them.
Tell us about your trip to Nudie's. Tell them what Nudie's is.
Okay. Nudie, Nudie made all of the Western movie stars, Western shirts and suits and things that were Western. Well, he was known. His company still does that. Well, Jack Lloyd got married. Met a girl and married her while we were in California. And Bob called me. He came over one morning and said, "Child, I'm going to take you to get a union card now." And he said, "I'm going to take you to Nudie and get you a Texas Playboy uniform." And he said, "And I'm going to put you on bass." And I said, "Well, Bob, I don't know if I can play bass." He said, "Yes, you can." He said, "Because you're a thoroughbred. I know you can do it." And of course, he took me over to Nudie's, and they fitted me for a Texas Playboy uniform, and I started playing bass. And
she's still playing bass.
And I was, I say that most people my age are either in a nursing home, maybe in a cemetery, but I'm still on the bandstand dancing with a bass fiddle.
Tell us about the time you were with Festus. I can't remember his name right now. What was his name, real name?
Ken
Curtis.
Ken Curtis. Well, I just worked a thing with him one night, and it was, if anybody remembers, Al Dexter's barn. Across the street from the Sportatorium, he had a big, big ballroom there. And they booked Ken Curtis in there. And that was before Festus was invented. And anyway, I got to play bass behind him.
Tell us about the time you sat in with the recording session with Buddy Holly.
Well, I didn't get to play with Buddy Holly, but I was married to Tommy Alsup, who was his guitar player at the time. And we both did studio work, but I didn't work with Buddy Holly because he was with the Crickets, and Joe B. was the bass player with them. And but my husband played guitar, so he worked with them and went on the tours. And when the plane crashed, I was sitting in Odessa where we had the band, the Southern Airs. I was sitting there watching TV, and a bulletin came over that Buddy Holly and the Big Bopper and Richie Valens had been killed in the plane crash. And excuse me. I jumped up because I knew that Tommy, who was my husband at the time, was supposed to have been on that plane. And so the phone rang just about that time because I almost had a heart attack when they said the plane had crashed. And the phone rang at the same time, and it was Tommy, and he said, "I'm okay." I gave my seat to Richie Valens. And they kept his wallet or his briefcase, I can't remember which he told me. They kept it for 7 years, and he got it back, and we had divorced after that, but I saw him, and he said that I just got back my wallet about 3 months ago, and he said the only thing it had in it was a comb and your picture. And I said, "Well, I'm kind of glad that I wasn't playing bass fiddle with Buddy Holly, because if two of us, my husband and myself, were with him, we might both had been on that plane." And I said, "Well, I'm glad it was my picture that went through that crash instead of me."
Tell us about some of the fun times, some memorable events that you had with the band while playing with Bob Wills and your tours. Any little funny moments that just stand out?
Well, let me see. I enjoyed every day with them. And they all treated me like their sister, like my brothers did. And, one day, we were traveling. We weren't traveling in Bob's bus. We were traveling in cars. And me and Eldon Shamlin, the guitar player, and Billy Bowman, and not Skeeter, because he wasn't in there then. Anyway, we were all rehearsing a song. And Eldon said, "I wish we had a guitar in here so I could play a G chord so I'd know where to start singing the song, you know." And I told Eldon, I was a teenager, I said, "Eldon, I can do that. I can hum a G." So they all laughed at me. They said, "Oh, yeah, she's got perfect pitch." And it was the biggest joke. So we got to the gig, and that afternoon I walked on the stage, and Skeeter, the piano player, he was riding with Bob in another car. So this was all separate from him knowing about it. Well, Skeeter called me over there because he was tuning the piano. He called me over and he said, "Louise, come over here." I said, "Okay." He said, "Would you hum me a G so I can get this piano in tune?" And I thought, "I'm going to kill you one of these days." Well, anyway, that night, Bob, when he called me up to sing my song, he reached over to me and he said, "Child, could you hum me a G so I can get my fiddle in tune?" So we had stopped at one of those novelty shops, and I bought some really hot gum. I gave some to Skeeter, and he choked for about 30 minutes. And I looked at Bob, and I held his gum up. I said, "Bob, got some gum for you here. It's really good." He said, "Don't you give me any of that hot gum." So this is the kind of days I had with Bob and the Playboys.
Bob Wills was known for his genius at improvisation, innovation. Can you tell us an example where you saw that in action? You know, he was known for taking sounds of the mariachi or playing different pitches, playing different harmony, incorporating little sounds of bluegrass or the big swing band. Can you tell us how you saw a little bit that genius in action?
Well, it was just everything he did. That band was so unique that today there's lots of bands out there that play Western swing, and they're great, great musicians. But if you were not a part of Bob Wills' Texas Playboy Band, you do not have you don't hear that touch. And so far, nobody's had that touch.
I agree. The queen of Texas and Western swing, Louise Rowe, right here.
Thank you.
I'm going to bring that microphone down to the audience, and you keep that for the two of you. And then this is for you.
Thank you.
Any questions, comments, stories, Bob Wills stories, what he meant to you, what he meant to your parents or grandparents? I can tell you about my parents and grandparents. He electrified this state. I don't know where you're from, but he electrified Texas. Questions, comments for Louise or Carolyn? Stories, reminiscences. Incidentally, there was a lady, a patron called earlier today. Bonnie had a question for Carolyn. Bonnie, are you here? Okay.
Thank you. I already talked to you, Louise, but Carolyn, and you were probably too young, but my mom played in Dallas in a band called Patty Lou and the Texas Sweethearts, and obviously named it around the time of the Bob Wills Band. She played in the Sportatorium. She played on the Big D Jamboree. She played all around the same time frame. But I just wanted to know if you'd ever heard of them, or I'd already talked to Louise, and I thought maybe I'd trigger maybe some pictures with Louise, because she's probably 5 years older than Louise, but she played the lead guitar.
Is she still with us?
No.
Okay.
No.
Oh, darn, I wish I, if it was Dallas, was it like 1950?
Well, so her time frame in Dallas that she played was probably 1944, 45
oh, yeah.
to 1955-ish, yeah.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Darn.
Awesome.
I can get you in touch with the Texas History Museum. Maybe they call me next week. Any other questions, comments for Carolyn or Louise? I'll get you in the back so I don't have to come back up. Questions, comments, stories? Okay, let me go to the back. I was hoping y'all would have stories. Did any of you go to a Bob Wills concert? One person? Two? Tell me about the time you were at a Bob Wills concert. Where?
One time I think in Fort Worth, but I don't remember all the places I've seen him. Down at the Longhorn Ballroom, maybe. And there was a place, it seemed to me like there was a place up around Denton or Sanger or Gainesville that we seen.
What about Panther Hall, maybe?
I don't remember.
He used to play down on Industrial. Was it Bob's Bar, Barn or something like that?
Bob's Ranch House.
There you go.
That's the place where he had stalls built for his stallions and where he would ride Punkin through the crowd and up on the stage. I know, I just think that's amazing.
You do great. I was in Tulsa the night your father passed. I was listening to this station and they announced that. And then all of a sudden, they started playing Bob Wills music. I love your father. He was a great innovator, and he always will be special.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I saw Bob in 1962 at the Longhorn Ballroom. He had Gene Crownover on one steel and Maurice Anderson on the other. It was a swinging band.
Any other questions, comments, or protests? Reminisces.
I have a comment, and that is I'd like to say that you look beautiful, Louise. You would never know that you're your age at all. You're absolutely gorgeous.
More importantly, she's gorgeous on the inside. I don't know that. Oh. Questions, comments, stories. There we go. Down in the. I think I saw some hands. Okay, let's do.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm John Stutler. I'm a clarinet player and a sax player on Louise's band. And I just want to let you know what a joy it is to work with Louise these days. A couple of years ago, actually about 3 years ago, Louise had a chance to start a band at a place over in Euless called the Texan Kitchen. And Louise said she'd never been a band leader, she'd never worked with guys, she'd never kicked anybody around, never had to explain anything 16 times, any of that stuff. But she started that band, and about a year in, I had the chance to come play with her, and I've been playing with that band for a couple of years on the clarinet and the saxophone. Every single week, she fires somebody. And then hires them right back. There's lots of love on that band. I just want you to know that what you're seeing up here is a work of love. And it's been that way for me for the last 2 years. So I think Louise carried that, a lot of that tradition that Bob started, carried it with her all those years, and now she runs her own band. So I just wanted to let you know that. Thanks.
There were comments over here, questions over in this, okay. I'm going to have you pass the mic down here.
This is for Bob Wills' daughter. We recently went through Turkey, Texas, and the old bus is there. And there is a museum there. We didn't have time to go through it. We were headed to. Where was your childhood? Was Bob Wills born in Turkey? And where was your childhood at?
Now, he was actually born in Kitakwe, but he grew up, he kind of claimed Turkey as his hometown. I grew up on Route 66, literally. I was born at the in Fresno at the Triple B Ranch, which was his dream. He was happier there, I think, than anywhere, because he got to have his horses. But then we moved to Sacramento, where he bought the Wills Point, that six-acre entertainment. And from there, it was Dallas, Oklahoma City, Tulsa, Amarillo, Abilene. And usually we went back a few times, so it was interesting. But I do recommend Turkey if anybody wants a different experience. It'll be great music, and you usually have to contend with some sort of weather, but it's really special. Well, I stay in Childress. There is one hotel, and the good news is it just sold to the mayor, and they're taking care of it. It's going to be brought back, and then I want to stay there again. But Childress isn't that far.
I was a college student in 1953 and went to Arkalala Festival in Arkansas City, Kansas, at a Bob Wills dance in 1953. At that particular night, they had three dances, a rock and roll dance, a big band dance, and a Bob Wills dance. And the Bob Wills dance was at the Armory. You could hardly get in there. You could, so many people, you could hardly dance. And I just bet you might have been in that band.
I was there.
There you are.
It was some night. And when he was on the stage, it made hair stand up on the back of your neck.
said when he was on stage that made the hair stand up on the back of his neck.
One last question or comment. Thank you all for sharing your stories. Thank you, Louise, for sharing your stories. Thank you, for Carolyn, for sharing your stories. After the program, we're going to be around for more questions and answers, but enjoy the music and the more of Louise Rowe and her Texan Playboys.
Hello.
Also, the dancers tonight, let's give a word for our dancers. Susanna and Kilroy Escalmente.
Tom, I would like everybody to know that I have some CDs out front, and we did some radio shows when I first joined Bob's band, and they made copies of everything for us, and I have CDs of those radio shows out there. And then I got all of the ladies that sang with Bob. I got them together with the guys, the Texas Playboys, and we did a CD out in California, and it's out there too if anybody would like to have a collector's item. That's what they are.
I'm sorry, is there a bass player in the house?
Let's hear it for Louise once again.
I think we'll play some more Bob Wills music. It'd be all right with y'all.
Thank you.
Sounds like Dexter Rowe on that fiddle right there.
Twilight falls, evening shadows find. There 'neath the stars, a maiden so fair divine. As she whispers a silent prayer. That old maiden prayer. Yes, sir. That's a boy's fiddle. That's the way it's done, friends, right there.
Oh, that's so good. One more time, great big hand, L.J. Pritchett singing that song for you.
Thank you very much.
We're going to bring Teresa Anderson up here. Y'all may remember Maurice Anderson, steel player. Well, this is Teresa. She's going to sing an old tune.
Thank you, John. My husband, I lost him in 2013, but he was also a member of Bob Wills' band.
Yeah.
And we have lots of memories and stories that he had told me about being on the band, and kind of like the ones that Louise is told, only they might be a little bit more X-rated. But anyway. And I also had the opportunity to, I'm a voice coach, and I had the opportunity to teach Bob's great-grandchildren at our first camp in Gainesville. It was my honor, I can tell you that for sure.
Here's that old favorite, Straighten Up and Fly Right.
The buzzard took the monkey for a ride in the air. The buzzard thought the monkey was on the square. The buzzard looked the monkey right dead in the eye. He said, your story's touching, but it sounds like a lie. So straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and do right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in jiving. What's the use in dying? Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. The buzzard told the monkey, you're choking me. So release your lung and I will set you free. The buzzard looked the monkey right dead in the eye. He said, your story's touching, but it sounds like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and do right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Woo! Your story's touching, but it sounds like a lie. So straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and do right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Fly right. Thank you very much.
Teresa Anderson, everybody. Let's go back to LJ. He's got that voice. He's got that voice.
Me.
But we're not going to let him sing right now. This is Dexter Rowe going to sing this one. Keeper of My Heart.
The sun for me would always shine. The fate has ruled that we must part. You'll be the keeper of my heart. Each night now down upon my knees, I pray that you remember me. And when we're many miles apart, you'll be the keeper of my
buddy. Here comes Joe. Everybody. Paul Dexter. We want you to know that for this next song, as in all of our songs, the dance floor is open. Now, that's all the way along through here and over there and over there and then over on that side. And, of course, up on the stage for these folks over here. A little In the Mood for you right here.
One, two, three, and...
Dale Moore Sr., Louise. Thank you. In the Mood. Couple number 16, ladies and gentlemen, right there. Del Morris, Ray Price, fiddle player right here, boys, girls. Jay Pritchett. You know, the music's fun. The music's alive. It bounces. It makes you feel good. There's nothing weird in it. You certainly don't have any weird lyrics, you know. And the only rap we do is at Christmas time when we do presents. So, you know, we don't do any heavy metal because there's no tuba on the band. What are you going to do? We're going to do Western Swing. That's what we're going to do. And right now we're going to do probably the most popular Western Swing tune ever done, ever. You want to guess what it is? Who said that?
Faded Love, here we go. Buddy Stevens once more. Here comes Joe. Morris Sr.
Goodbye, I remember our
Time for a couple more before we do that question and answer session with Louise and Carolyn and Tom and anybody, whatever, that kind of thing. Who's got a question for him? A personal question. Anybody? Anybody? Got one or two. I see three, maybe four. We got like four, so that's good. Right now, we're going to do one that everybody knows. I mean, you've been singing this song since it came on the radio 150 years ago. Here is Dexter Rowe with Miles and Miles of Texas.
I was born in Louisiana, down on the old bayou. Raised on shrimp and catfish and mammy's good gumbo. I got the rambling fever, said goodbye to mom and pa. I crossed the old Red River, and this is what I saw. I saw miles and miles of Texas, all the stars up in the sky. I saw miles and miles of Texas, gonna live here till the day I die. Come on, Aaron. I rolled up in Austin, the cradle of the West. Just ask any cowboy and he'll tell you it's best. I met a Texas beauty, I got friendly with her paw. I looked into her big blue eyes and this is what I saw. I saw miles and miles of Texas, all the stars up in the sky. I saw miles and miles of Texas, I'm gonna live here till the day I die. Hit it again. Broncos, I made every rodeo until I met a tough one. You know his name was Devil Joe. I grabbed hold of his bridle just to ride that old outlaw. He threw me from the saddle, and this is what I saw. I saw miles and miles of Texas, all the stars up in the sky. I saw miles and miles of Texas, I'm gonna live here till the day I die. Well, I'm gonna live here till the day I die. Oh, I die.
This is Dexter Rowe.
You know, a lot of things about Western Swing come to light when you take a study of it. As the video said, all these different styles of music came into play. So did New Orleans jazz. So did Dixieland. That was part of what was part of the music. And we're going to do one of those tunes right now. This is called the St. James Infirmary Blues. Oh, sorry. There is audience participation. And we'll show you where, and you'll know what to do. Because it's fun. Went down to the St. James Infirmary to see my baby. was stretched out on that long white table, so cold, so cool, so fair. Then I went up to see the doctor. She's very low, he said. When I went back to see my baby, good Lord, y'all, she's a-laying there dead. Help me out now. Hidey, hidey, hi.
Hidey, hidey, hi.
Hoody, hoody, ho.
Hoody, hoody, ho.
Heedy, heedy, hee.
Heedy, heedy, hee.
Oh, Lord, I done got them blues. Help me out, buddy, will you? On the corner by the square, all the usual folks were there now. He was serving them drinks all day. He said, let her go, God bless her. Wherever she may be, she can search this whole wide world over and never find a bigger chump than me. Here we go, hidey, hidey, hi. Hoody, hoody, ho.
Hoody, hoody, ho.
Heedy, heedy,
hee. Heedy, heedy,
hee. Oh, Lord, I got them blues. Me right, box back coat, Stetson hat. You put a $20 gold piece on my watch chain, so the good Lord will know that I died standing pat. Give me six gamblers to carry my coffin and six chorus girls to sing me a tune. I want a Dixieland band dancing round my head, a playing hallelujah right along. Here we go,
hidey, hidey, hi.
Hoody, hoody, ho.
Hoody, hoody, ho.
Heedy, heedy,
hee.
You know, that's pretty bad. We probably ought to try that again. Now, come on, help me out. Hidey, hidey, hi.
Hidey, hidey,
hi. Hoody, hoody, ho.
Hoody, hoody,
hee. Heedy, heedy, hee.
Heedy, heedy,
hee. Oh, Lord, I got them blues. Well, now that's the end of my story. Let's all have another round of booze. And if anybody should ever ask you, I've got the St. James Infirmary blues.
John Stutler, yay!
Oh, thanks.
And for our dancers, man. Great, great, great.
Folks, we are the Texan Playboys. You've been listening to such stars as L.J. Pritchett on the guitar singing, Dexter Rowe on the fiddle singing, Buddy Stevens playing right now, Joe Settlemyer's playing right now. I bet you Dale Morris Jr. is going to sing or play right in just a second.
How about Dale Morris Sr.?
That's right, Dale Morris Sr. Sorry about that. Dale, get it. singing good, back up and singing great for you, Teresa Anderson. My name is John Stutler, and a great big hand for Louise Rowe. The band says good night. Louise says, step over here for the question and answer session. Oh, look at this. Thank you. You're so great.
Look at this. They're all standing up.
And I'm going to go out in front.
Oh, you got to go out in front for this?
If anybody wants one of those collector's items.
Okay.
I'm going to put my ex on it.
Okay.
Give her a chance to come out front so she can meet you. Also, let's hear it for Kilroy and Susanna.
Yeah. And let's hear it for you guys. You made the night possible. Thank you so much for being here. We really do appreciate it. Thanks.
See y'all Friday night. Thank you, Louise Rowe and her Texan Playboys.